These canines and their handlers go into some of the most dangerous situations when we have to face that situation. They are the ones that we call. So to answer your question, absolutely vital that they're prepared, that our canine handlers and that our canines have the proper equipment to remain safe. Mrs. Sisson happened to see one of the dogs on a newscast and saw the dogs running around and saw that it didn't have a ballistic vest and said, I'm going to change that. Talked to her husband. They reached after us and said, how many dogs do you have without a vest? Said, we have 5 dogs. I said, we're going to change that. And then today said, you know what, we were thinking overnight, we're not only going to purchase the additional 5 vests for the canines that need it, we're going to buy a new vest for every dog every time the sheriff's office purchases a new canine.
The relationships that we share with our community are ones that we cherish the most.
Hey, this was about protecting the people who protect us. If everybody gets involved with their community, the firemen, the police officers, even teachers, if everybody came together as one, it would be a much better community.
Our agency, I believe, works very well with the community, and their community respects our agency. And for them to reach out to us and provide what they provided for these last 5 dogs is unbelievable.